Good evening. You're watching To The Point. I'm Preeti Chaudhary. The national capital is reeling under an acute heat wave and a massive water crisis. There are water wars raging in several parts of Delhi. And to make matters worse, water tanker mafia is operating with impunity. India Today now blows the lid of this black marketing of water. Here is part one of India Today's special investigation, Operation Water Mafia.
India's capital, Delhi, is thirsty and parched. Despite the Aam Aadmi Party government's promise of free and clean water in taps for Delhiites, wars on the streets for every drop as tankers struggle to quench Delhi's thirst. As the capital goes dry, the notorious tanker mafia is having a free run. This ruthless lobby, busy fleecing a thirsty population of the capital for a few extra bucks. To expose this racket, going without any checks, India Today's undercover team reached Delhi's Sangam Vihar, where we met Ritesh, a tanker mafia operator who runs this business from his home. Our undercover team sought water to build a house.
Thanks, sir. Thank you, sir. How
are you?
सेक्टर 4 में कुशवाहा में मुझे लोकेशन भेज दूंगा आपको।
इसमें आता है 2100 लीटर पानी।
अच्छा।
₹1500।
2100 लीटर है, हमें तो ज़्यादा चाहिए। इससे बड़ा भी है?
टैंक है नीचे।
हाँ हाँ टैंक
है। मांगी फिर है हमारे पास 12000 लीटर का।
हाँ।
आपका टैंक कितना बड़ा है?
12000 15000 का 12000 दे दो चल जाएगा।
हमारा पूरा खाली हो जाना चाहिए।
हाँ
और नहीं हुआ टैंक आपका भर गया तो उठेगा नहीं।
नहीं वो हमारा ही है
पूरा खाली हो जाए और बढ़िया बात है। पानी बचा तो उठेगा नहीं। जैसे आप लोग ऊपर टंकी चढ़ा रहे हैं मोटर से उठ जाए और ऊपर
The water mafia operates in almost every street of Sangam Vihar, the worst hit by Delhi's water crunch. Two streets away, we met Mohan, who not only had an illegal borewell, but also a huge water tank inside his home. Our spy cameras captured the tanker being filled from the borewell, throwing all norms out the window. We met Mohan here and asked him for a water tanker.
भैया, पानी का टैंकर चाहिए।
बैंक का लोन, बैंक का लोन।
छोटा बड़ा?
बड़ा।
2200 रुपए। कितना लीटर का है?
4.5, 4.5 से काम
नहीं होगा।
ठीक है।
4,500 लीटर 2200 रुपये।
पानी
मुझे 12000 लीटर चाहिए। ये गाड़ी है 12000 तो बैंक वाले दे दोगे? कितने का पड़ेगा? 4,500 का
2200 रुपये।
Then Mohan told us that the groundwater level is falling and that they're having difficulty filling the water tanker.
कितने उस पर आ रहा है पानी अभी नीचे?
अरे एक घंटा में एक गाड़ी भरी जा रही है।
एक घंटे में एक गाड़ी? कितने फुट पर है पानी?
शायद 650 फुट। 650 फुट
पर।
The tanker mafia is earning lakhs by selling water from illegal borewells, stealing Delhi's already rapidly falling water table.
पानी की वो तो मकान बनाने के लिए मिल जाएगा हमें।
यार मकान बनाओ चाहे नहाओ चाहे मिलो कुछ करो मगर एक दिन छोड़ के एक गाड़ी चाहिए।
हाँ एक दिन छोड़ के एक गाड़ी चाहिए।
The tanker mafia brazenly extracts water from illegal tube wells which dot the Wazirabad area of Yamuna Khadar in Delhi. Here water tankers are being filled openly. We met Ramesh who runs one such illegal tube well.
आप क्या करते हो आपका क्या?
हमारा तो टैंकर आओ ना भर दे।
आप भर देते हो बस। कितने पैसे लेते हो?
जैसा टैंकर है।
फिर भी
500
लीटर का टैंकर होगा तो कितना? 500 रुपए।
Buying water from illicit tube wells has become a part of life in these parts of the capital. We wanted to know how many water tankers Ramesh fills daily and whether he could arrange a tanker for construction work.
और आपके यहाँ कितने टैंकर आ जाते हैं डेली?
तो हमारे
कोई है टैंकर वाले या हमें लाना पड़ेगा टैंकर?
मैं बात
करता
हूँ टैंकर वाले।
ठीक है, हमें ना हम गोडाउन बना रहे हैं।
कई जगह बनाने
हैं। पानी कैसा आपका?
पानी मीठा जी।
पानी मीठा है?
यमुना का लगता ही होगा पानी तो।
अभी तालाब हुआ
हम यहाँ नए नए इस एरिया में को पकड़े
पंडित है या और
भी है उनकी अपनी सेटिंग है ना।
आप दिल्ली में पानी गिर रहे हैं? सारी दिल्ली में। सारी दिल्ली में गिर रहे पानी
यही से। आप यहाँ से भर रहे हैं?
कई जगह है यहाँ से भर।
अच्छा
कितना ट्यूब लग रहे थे? कितने लग रहे थे?
सामने लग रहा।
अच्छा सामने कहाँ पर? नीचे उतर गए?
नहीं सामने कमरा बन
रहा। अरे वो लग तो रहा सामने।
अच्छा ये रोड पे लगा रखे तो मेरे को रोकता नहीं। मैं रोड पे लगा रखे तो रोकता नहीं।
पानी कमी तो है ही ना पहाड़ ना राजस्थान यहाँ नहीं जम लो बराबर बेरी तालाब और रोड पर रोक कौन रुकते हैं।
The big question, who will rein in Delhi's water looters or will the water mafia continue to plunder Delhi of its precious pani? With Nitin Jain in Delhi, this is India Today's Special Investigation Team.
Meanwhile, Delhi Minister Atishi has blamed Haryana government for the water crisis in Delhi, accusing it of not releasing enough water for the capital. India Today's Special Investigation Team tried to investigate this claim.
Large parts of Delhi struggling for water. But in the areas hit by the worst ever water crisis, there's endless flouting of norms. This is the Bhavana area of Delhi. Bore wells are banned in the entire capital, but here this law is only on paper. Our team reached the area around the Munak Canal of Bhavana. This is the canal where water from Haryana is supplied to Delhi. The canal is a lifeline for the capital, supplying a bulk of the water and has been the subject of an open political war. But this area also has among the highest numbers of illegal borewells. On the banks of the canal, which are used to illegally pump water into water tankers, the water mafia running with impunity. India Today's undercover team met the water mafia operatives who were ready to supply water to factories but at a hefty price.
पानी तो हम फिर यहाँ जो जो लेता है उसको तो देखते ही हैं। यूँ है एक दो घंटा लेट हो गया फ्री लाइट भाग गया जब लेट सेट हो सकता है।
रेट क्या आपका टैंकर मतलब?
सेक्टर 5 में कौन सब लोग है?
इसके सामने एक और उसके सामने।
अच्छा 20 लोग है। 20 लोग है वहाँ दे दूँगी वैसे वो तो वहाँ का 1200 रेट है।
कितने लीटर है?
5000 लीटर। अभी यहाँ का 800 रेट है क्योंकि यहाँ से वहाँ तक पेट्रोल जाएगा डीजल और भी।
मीठा पानी मिलेगा?
हाँ मीठा पानी तो चेक करवा देंगे।
नहर के पास में ही लगा हुआ है या फिर
नहर के पास में, हम तो भक्के वहीं से लाते हैं।
But where is the administration and how can the water loot continue in the open? What gives this brazen confidence to Delhi's Pani ke Lutere?
और हमें कोई पुलिस वगैरह ये सब की पंगा वंगा तो नहीं होगा? पुलिस वगैरह का पंगा वंगा तो नहीं होगा?
ना वो तो हमारी सरदर्दी है, उनको तो पैसे देने पड़े हैं, मंथली देनी पड़ती है, यहाँ भी देनी पड़ती है।
तो आप दिन में कितने दे दोगे हमें, कितना लीटर पानी दे पाओगे?
आप कितना लेना, मेरे को कुछ ऐसा अंदाजा बताओ।
50,000 तो लगेगा
ही। 50,000 लीटर दे देंगे।
दिन का दिक्कत नहीं होगा?
नहीं,
कोई भी दिन ऐसा ना चलना चाहिए क्योंकि मेरा फैक्ट्री के ऊपर फिर मतलब मैन्युफैक्चरिंग के ऊपर नहीं होना चाहिए दिक्कत।
अच्छा, इसलिए 10 टैंकर चाहिए आपको।
तो रेट
ऐसा तो होगा जैसे 2 टैंक 10,000 लीटर गया, 1 घंटे के बाद फिर 10,000 लीटर
वो ठीक है। अब मैं ये नहीं करूँ हमको एक साथ ही आप 50,000 लीटर दो, वो तो बिल्कुल पॉसिबल ही नहीं है।
अच्छा, पुलिस वाले ज़्यादा परेशान करने लग गए तो पिछली बार सब ट्रैक्टर बंद कर दिए थे।
हाँ,
रात रात को काम चल रहा था।
हाँ,
फिर सभी ट्रैक्टर वालों ने 20,000 रुपये इकट्ठे करके दिए, पेट्रोल ले दिया।
These water tankers from the banks of the Lifeline Canal are openly going to factories. No checks, no questions asked, no one to stop them.
वैसे ये वाला कैनाल तो हरियाणा का है ना, ये जो साथ साथ चल रहा
है? हाँ,
तो इससे पानी नहीं लेते हैं?
नहीं लेते।
अच्छा, इसके साथ लगाने के चक्कर में मीठा पानी मिल सकता
है?
Politics is raging in the name of water, but everyone seems to be silent in this corruption trade in an especially scorching summer. With Arvind Ojha and Shreya Chatterjee in Delhi, this is India Today's Special Investigation Team.
Meanwhile, the Supreme Court has come down heavily on the Delhi government over the prevalence of the tanker mafias and have asked what measures have been taken against the mafia. The top court asked the Delhi government to explain steps taken to prevent water wastage. A special bench also took on the Delhi government, saying that if it cannot deal with the tanker mafia, it will ask the Delhi police to take action. I want to cut across immediately to my colleague Nalini, who's joining us, as well as Shreya. But Nalini, coming to you first, would you detail for us on what the top court said today regarding the water mafias that operate with impunity in the national capital?
Well, Preeti, the vacation bench of the Supreme Court was hearing a petition by the Delhi government that was asking for the water that has been sent by Himachal Pradesh to be released by Haryana so that it can reach the national capital. And during the course of this hearing, the vacation bench has slammed the Delhi government, asking them what action they've taken against the water mafia that is functioning in the national capital, which is leading to loss of water. There is spillage, and of course, there is the tanker mafia, because of which the water is not reaching the residents. In fact, it was told in the court that almost 52% of the water that is coming to the national capital is actually being wasted. Either it's being spilled during the transport or it is being taken over by the mafia, because of which it's not able to reach the citizens. So on this aspect, the court has asked the Delhi government to come back by as early as tomorrow with all the steps that have been taken against the water mafia, whether any FIRs have been registered, whether any action has been taken. And the Delhi government has to now tomorrow come back and give its response before the top court on what action has been taken. The court has also warned that if the Delhi government is not able to do anything, then the matter will be handed over to the central government through the Delhi police, and the Delhi police will be asked to step in and then take action. So it remains to be seen what happens tomorrow. It's going to be a firecracker of a hearing, and we'll have to see what response the Delhi government gives regarding what action they have taken against the water mafia.
Well, Narani, we're going to keep a keen eye on that. Thank you there for joining us on the developments taking place at the vacation bench of the top court of the country. Meanwhile, I want to pull in Shreya Chatterjee, who's getting us more on what really is going on where the national capital is concerned, where water stolen, delivered by a network of mafia which operates with utter impunity. Shreya.
Well, absolutely, Preeti. You know, the entire report that we've actually unearthed suggests that this impunity continues with the operation of also the authorities, because the tanker mafias who's been stung by us clearly suggest that they can run this because they pay off to the police, they pay off to the SDM. They've very categorically taken the authorities that they have to pay off. One of the mafias also went ahead to suggest that last time when they had faced a similar trouble, all the tanker mafias involved, they had individually pulled up money and then they had given it to the police so that their operation could run. So clearly, this is water we are talking about, industrial use. So at a time when the people of Delhi are not getting water supply, there is a rampant misuse of water, unregulated water, unchecked, illegally, that's being taken and delivered for industrial purposes. Definitely, there is a lack of the authorities on ground to regulate and put checks and balance. Today, after this investigation, we have seen the water minister write to the LG suggesting that there is lacking of cooperation from the Delhi Jal Board. Mm-hmm. Additionally, she suggested that she had also written that DJB had reduced the tankers during the summer season, which could have led to these illegal supply actually monitoring. She's also suggested that ACP rank officials should actually monitor and patrol the Munnar Canal region, because this is the stretch where we've actually got these mafias operating. This is the same stretch through which the Haryana water is coming to Delhi. So now she suggested that there should be patrolling in this region to ensure that we can see that no such theft is continued from here onwards.
You know, Shreya, what was it that our team found out, especially because one claim of the Aam Aadmi Party government has been that it is the Haryana government that is not allowing the regular flow of water to the national capital. Our team did visit the border areas of Haryana, especially the canal in which Delhi is dependent on. What did we find?
Preeti, you know, we need to understand that the entire water that comes to Delhi from Haryana comes through the Munnar Canal. Through Kakori, then it reaches through the Delhi sub-branch in CLC, through which it actually reaches the 7 water treatment plant. Subsequently, from there, the water is released to the people of Delhi. Now, what we do understand that there has been an economic survey report of this sewage, and we've also understood an inspection that was carried out by the Upper Yamuna River body. They have suggested that Haryana is releasing their quantity of water, and at Kakori, when they monitored it on last Sunday, it was showing that over 1100 cubic of water, which is more than the share of Haryana's water, is being shed. But when it is being registered at the point of Bawana, the tally comes down to 960, which suggests that there is an 18% loss of water through leakages and through theft. So that needs a proper check and balance. We're literally losing 18% of water. The allowed norm is 5%. So this is something that authorities with cooperation should be tackling and ensuring that people's basic right is water. And if we cannot even manage water loss, that is to the amount of 18%, that is something that really points out to the lapses on the ground on part of the authorities.
All right, appreciate you joining us, Shreya, and the team who's conducted that sting there, exposing the mafias across the national capital. And also, interesting, because there's a political spin-off on what we are witnessing in the national capital, a BJP versus Aam Aadmi Party face-off, but we're keeping away from that, putting the focus on the government of Delhi coming good on delivering what they promised, which is drinking water and water to the national capital. Tomorrow is a crucial hearing in the Supreme Court, and we're going to follow it up for sure.